We are going to continue into chapter 9. We will be working on 9.9, which is Pythagorean theorem. All right, let's first start off with parts of a right triangle. So in a right triangle, what you have is you have the right angle. The sides that make the right angle are called the legs. And the side opposite of the right angle is called the hypotenuse. Now, what we know about this is the hypotenuse is always the longest side of the right triangle. So when you look at a right triangle, you have to know what part you are given and what part you are finding. So we have our two legs and we have our hypotenuse. Now, in Pythagorean theorem, what we do is we can say this a couple different ways, okay? So Pythagorean theorem simply says that if I take the leg of a right triangle and I square it and I add it to the other leg of the right triangle and I square it, that will equal the hypotenuse squared. In other words, what they will say is they will say this is leg A, this is leg B, and the hypotenuse is C. So if we talk to it that way, you might hear it said A squared plus B squared equals C squared. Now, a couple other things about that. If you notice, the hypotenuse is always on the side by itself. So we take the leg, square it, added to the leg squared, and that will equal the hypotenuse square. Okay, so the first part that we want to do the following lengths form a right triangle? Well, every right triangle has to follow the theorem of the Pythagorean theorem. So what we simply do is we plug our numbers in. Remember I said that the hypotenuse has to be the biggest and it is opposite of the right angle. So here's my right angle. This would be the hypotenuse, this would be a leg, and this would be a leg. So to plug this in, we would simply say 3 squared plus 4 squared do you equal 5 squared? Well, 3 squared is 9, 4 squared is 16, and 5 squared is 25. 9 plus 16 is 25. So yes, these three sides would make a right triangle. Okay, let's try the other one here. So when I look, here's my right angle. Opposite of it, here's my hypotenuse. This is a leg. This is a leg. So what we're going to do is we're simply going to go 5 squared plus 12 squared. Do you equal 14 squared? Well, 5 squared is 25. 12 squared is 144. 14 squared is 196. If I add those together, I get 169. That does not equal 196. So we would say, no, those do not form a right triangle. Okay, on this last one, they tell me A, B, and C. So I just plug those in. So 2.5 squared plus 1.2 squared. Do you equal 2.7 squared? Okay, so we start off with the 2.5. So we got 2.5 squared, and that's going to equal 6.25 plus, now we go 1.2 squared, and that equals 1.44, and then our last measurement that we need is we go 2.7 squared, and that is 7.29. Now we add these together. So that's going to give me 7.69. Are they the same? No, so that does not form a right triangle. Okay, so that's how we determine if it's going to work or not. Next, the other thing we can do with this is we can look for any side of a right triangle. The trick here is you have to figure out what you're given and what you're looking for. So here it says, find the missing side of the triangle. Right answer is a simplified radical and decimal to the nearest tenth. So the first thing I say is I say, okay, what am I looking for? Well, if I come across from the right angle, I am looking for the hypotenuse. So that means the 4 would be a leg and the 6 would be a leg. So I set this up and I say, okay, 4 squared plus 6 squared, that equals C squared. Well, 4 squared is 16, 6 squared is 36, and that equals C squared. We add that together, that would be 52 equals C squared. So now we have an equation, so we take the square root of both sides. So now what we do is we look at this and we say, okay, does the square root of 52 have any perfect square factors? So when we look at that, it has a factor of 4. So 4 times 13 is 52. So we would bring that out and it would be 2 square root of 13. So that is our simplified radical. Then we take a calculator, we punch that into the calculator, and we end up with 7.21 once to the nearest tenth. So we look at the second decimal place, and that's going to tell me my final answer would be 7.2. So I need my simplified radical, and I need the decimal answer. Okay, let's try another one. So if we look at this one, what am I looking for? I am looking for the hypotenuse again. I have a leg and a leg. So I start in 8 squared plus 8 squared, that equals C squared. 8 squared is 64 plus 64 equals C squared. Add that together, that's 128. Now we have C squared, so to undo that, we take the square root of both sides. So we end up with the square root of 128, which is 64 times 2. 64, the square root of that is 8. 8 square root of 2. That is my simplified radical. To find my decimal, I just simply take, punch that into a calculator, 8 square root of 2, and that's going to give us 11.31. We want to round to the nearest tenth, so the 1 would make it round to 11.3. And that is how we do that. Okay, let's try this next one here. We look at this one. What am I given? Well, here's a leg. I look, there's my right angle. This is the hypotenuse. So I am looking for another leg. Now, since I'm looking for another leg, it does not matter which one I put it in. Whether it be an A or B, it doesn't matter. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to say A squared plus 3 squared, and that equals 12 squared. Remember, the hypotenuse is always on the side by itself. So now we go A squared, 3 squared is 9, 12 squared is 144. We take that, we're solving an equation, so we just keep going, so we minus our 9. So A squared is equal to 135. Then at that point, we look at 135 and say, does it have any perfect square factors? And the answer would be yes, it does. So A is equal to 135 is going to break down into 9 times 15. So the square root of 9 gives me 3 square root of 15. Then from there, I want the approximate. So I take that, type it in, and I end up with 11.61, which is going to round just to simply 11.6. Okay, let's try another one. When I look at this problem, here's my right angle. So the 10 would be my hypotenuse. The 8 would be the leg. I'm looking for the other leg. So I'm going to go A squared plus 8 squared equals 10 squared. So 8 squared is 64. 10 squared is 100. So now I'm solving. I'm going to minus my 64 from both sides. So I'm left with A squared is equal to 36. Take the square root of both, and A would equal 6. Okay, there's no need for a decimal because it was a perfect square. So we know our answer is just simply 6. Okay, we can also do some story problems with these. I will tell you right now, anytime you do this, draw a picture. And since we're working with right triangles, every picture should have a right triangle in it. So it says here on a baseball diamond, okay, so if I draw a diamond, here's first base, second base, third base, and home. Okay, so if you kind of need to look at that, and it says the bases are 90 feet apart, and it wants to know how far will the catcher throw from home plate to second base. So if you notice, you have a right angle here. We have a right triangle where the sides are both 90. So those are my legs, and I'm looking for the hypotenuse. So I would simply go 90 squared plus 90 squared is equal to C squared. So now I take and go, okay, what is 90 squared? And that is 8,100. So C squared is equal to 8,100 plus 8,100. So we add that together, and that gives me 16,200. Then I take that, and I look for the largest perfect square in that. So we go second square root of 16,200. We're looking for the largest perfect square, and it would be a 90. So C is equal to 90 squared. So I'm going to go the square root of that is 90. And then that is going to give us square root of 2 left over. So the largest perfect square that goes in here, if you want to think of it, would be 8,100 times 2. So that's where the 90 is coming from. Sorry about that. I misspoke there. So then you would take that, convert it into a decimal. So that comes out to be 127.27. Since that number is a 7, that's going to round it up. So 127.3 feet. And that would be the throw from home plate to second base for the catcher to throw the ball. Okay, 127.3 feet. All right, let's take a look at some directional one. So we start off, it says a person rents a snowmobile and heads due north. So when we're on our piece of paper, remember we go north, south, west, east. Okay, so there's our little compass. So what we're going to do is we're going to start off, we rent a snowmobile, and we are going to go due north 6 miles. Then from there, it says we're going to turn and head west 9 miles. And we want to know how far are they from the snowmobile rental place. Okay, so this is our X. So when we look at that, we have the two legs. So we're going to go C squared is equal to 9 squared plus 6 squared. So C squared is equal to 81 plus 36. So C squared, add those together, and we end up with 81 plus 36, which is 117. Then we check, would it have any perfect square factors to it? And it does. It has a 9, so we take the square root of both sides. So C would equal 117, by the way, is going to be 9 times 13. So the square root of 9 comes out. We get 3 square root of 13. Then what we simply do is take that, punch it into the calculator, and we end up getting 10.81, which is 10.8 approximately miles from the rental place. Okay, and that is how we use Pythagorean theorem.